This week's parasha discusses the Yomim Tovim, the holidays on the Jewish calendar. And when it comes to Sukkos, it instructs us to shake the lulav, the esrog, the myrtle branch, and the willow branch. But what's interesting is that there is no reference to the word esrog in the Torah. It rather states, Pri Eitz Hadar, the fruit of the tree that is beautiful. And from here we derive that this is a reference to the esrog, because the esrog is a beautiful fruit. But there are many beautiful fruit out there. And besides, how do we define the beauty of a fruit? So the sages offer a different interpretation of this phrase, which says, the fruit of the tree Hadar that lives in the tree throughout the year, throughout all four seasons. Because if we wouldn't remove the esrog from the tree, it could remain there connected to the tree, no matter what the season may be. You know, changes in season or change in time affect us. When it's dark and cold outside in the mornings, it's hard to get up to go to shul. When we're on holiday and we're traveling, it's difficult to keep the laws of kashrus, of kosher, as we do back at home. The message of the esrog is consistency. It is continuously connected to its source, to its tree. No matter what the season may be, hot, cold, windy or humid, that's irrelevant. The esrog remains connected. And we too must be like the esrog as well. It shouldn't affect us, the temperature, or the environment, or where we are, or where we're traveling. We must remain connected to our source, to God, to Torah, and remember to be continuous and consistent in our commitment, doing that which is right and refraining from that which is wrong. Shabbat Shalom.